All right, it's crunch time here on The Jump. Ja Morant scoring 20 points, dishing 10 assists in the Grizzlies' victory over the Heat last night. He's now averaging 18.8 points, 6.5 assists per game. Zach, I don't know. We came in with high expectations. He's number two pick in the draft, but is he even exceeding those expectations?
For sure. He's shooting 43% from three, which nobody expected. And by the way, most rookies are bad. Most rookie point guards are really bad.
Right.
To play this position as a rookie is damn near impossible and to be productive at it. He's had an unbelievable first season.
He's fulfilling every expectation
right.
we all have had of him. He's showing the excitement he showed in college.
Athleticism. Crazy.
This is the stuff he's seen in college.
But the confidence.
That it would transfer to the NBA, and he's made a smooth transition.
The confidence, that when you say it doesn't transfer, right? Because some guys are like, oh, I'm tentative, how can I deal with the speed of the game? He just
goes
out there.
They get wide-eyed. Rookies get wide-eyed.
I love it.
It's never the same.
Love watching him. All right, the Washington Wizards shooting 81% in the first quarter, 78% in the fourth quarter, and their win over the Pistons last night. All offense for this team. They're ranked fourth in the league in points scored this year. Paul, are you buying the Wizards offense?
I'm buying it. Bradley Beal is spearheading this. He's having another great year. He should be an all-star despite their record. These guys have shooters galore. They have young guys who are up every single night. I'm buying it.
I love this. This is so much fun. You're not winning a title. Go do this instead.
Just score.
But that's they're an entertainment product this year. This is the end of our Washington Wizards serious basketball analysis because they're just fun. And we're almost 30 games into the season. You have no choice but to buy this as real somehow.
Yes.
You are who you are after like 25, 30 games,
right.
I believe.
Look, if you look at the bottom 10 teams by record in the NBA, none of them are as fun as the Washington Wizards.
No.
So there you go. Hey, look, it's Zion Williamson. He is getting closer to a comeback. Our Pelicans reporter, Andrew Lopez, says that Zion is fully weight-bearing and is putting up shots after practice. We can see some of those now. The Pelicans will see how he responds day-to-day. Zach, he's not playing full court here. When do you expect him back? Because this is fun, and we would like to see more of this.
Sounds like we're talking about like a wall or a structure. He's weight-bearing. He's fully weight-bearing, like this wall over here. I can't wait for him to come back. I mean, that's all. This Pelican season is essentially down the drain. This is all we have left to hope for, is that Zion comes back and lights the world on fire for a little bit.
In the era of low management, this new age NBA, if I'm the Pelicans, I sit him the rest of the year.
What?
I mean, they have nothing to gain by getting him out there playing. We've seen this happen.
Yes, they do.
What? They're not making the playoffs.
Yeah, but that's not the year. You're trying to develop the player.
Yeah, but... You don't want to risk any further.
If
he's been injured the
back.
Last 2 years.
I wouldn't
got
rush him back,
in
but
college.
There's no need to sit
injured.
Him, because then if he sits for a year, then we're going to spend all next season saying, he
practice.
Just missed a year of basketball.
I mean,
it's going to take him a while
practicing.
To get his rhythm back.
They did it with Ben Simmons, Joel
Embiid.
Yeah, but those guys had different kinds of injuries. This kind of injury should not require sitting for a year.
I mean,
year.
We don't know. Why is he sat for 3 months?
Because he had an injury. I think it was 2 months.
This injury requires 6 weeks.
Is it 6 to 8 weeks? He's around the 8 week mark. Someone has to check my math. So he's in
I'm
the ballpark.
Sure. I'm not sure.
Even if he sits another month,
but
let's say it takes an extra
this
month.
This is your franchise. This is the number one pick. This is who all the marketing dollars is going toward.
He's
that you
want to
have him
though.
Around for the next 5, 10 years. This is it, guys. You blew it with Anthony Davis. This is it. Don't take that chance on this kid.
I feel like those are, first of all, totally different medical staffs, very different, different people, everything, and different situations. I just don't understand. Why wouldn't you want this kid to have a half season to develop?
If I bring him back, it'll be for the last 10 games. Period.
If he's healthy,
I'm not taking
a
risk
on
my franchise player.
But it shouldn't be a risk if his knee is fully healed. Eventually, you got to play on it. Right?
And he's got to get play himself into playing shape and all that. Get developed. Like,
I don't want to.
When you miss
30 games and you be like, okay, here, go.
Right.
How do you get in shape for that? What's going to stop you from getting hurt again?
Well,
you know, there's nothing you can duplicate that. He doesn't have a preseason.
Are you pretending no one in the NBA has ever missed 30 games and there's not a model of how to come back?
This is a different animal. This is my franchise player. I'm banking everything on him. We lost Anthony Davis. I'm not going to lose him. I'm taking all the precautions to make sure that he's as ready as possible, period.
I don't know if sitting him is going to be the best course for your franchise.
Well, let's
player.
Develop Ball. Let's develop these other guys. We got a lot of guys need development.
They've already had a lot of time to develop. Let's get Zion on the floor.
I was
going to
say, I don't know. I just feel like if you're talking about him as your franchise player, to your point, you want the best Zion you can get, right, for next
Absolutely.
Year. So you want a guy who has played NBA minutes, right? He hasn't even played in regular season NBA game yet.
How do you even get in shape now? Like, what do you do to get in shape? I'll tell you what. You have preseason games, which he's not going to have. Mm-hmm. You have practices, which teams aren't doing right now. How do you get ready to throw him into a full-speed NBA game right now?
If Zion Williams needs to practice, this team will practice. Because to your point, it's not like they're doing anything else. And he is the franchise. So if they need to practice and they have guys not play the games, that will happen.
I'm more scared of preparing him to play than him actually playing.
I don't know, man. What do you think?
Taking to the extreme, your logic is like, well, why are the Wizards bothering to play Bradley Beal? They're not going anywhere. Just save Bradley Beal's legs for next season. If like, if a team
no,
is
you
like,
got to keep his trade stock up. Come on now. What are you talking about? He's going to a contender by the end of the year.
You know what I mean, though. It's like,
Bradley Beal can't be traded until this summer, but to your point.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports analysis and highlights, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.